yours.
That dreamers often lie.
In bed asleep while they dream things, true.
Oh, I see Queen Mab have been with you.
Queen Mab? What's she?
She is the fairy's midwife.
Oh, God.
Ah! And she comes in shape no bigger than an agate stone on the forefinger of an alderman. Drawn with the team of little Tommy over men's noses, they lie asleep. Her chariot, an empty hazelnut, made of joiner, squirrel, or old grub, time out of mind, the fairy's coachmakers. And in this state, she gallops night by night through lovers' brains, and then they dream of love, which oft the angry mad with blisters plays, because their breath is sweet meat, tainted are. Sometimes comes she with a tight pigtail to tickle a parson though he lies asleep, and then he dreams of another benefice.
Amen.
This is that very mad that plagues the maids of horsemen like, and baits the outlocks and foul sausage hairs, which, once untangled, much misfortune bodes. This is the hag when maids lie on their backs, that presses them, and learns them first to bear, making them women of good carriage. This is she!
Peace! Peace, Mercutio! Peace! Thou talkest of nothing!
True. I talk of dreams. To the children, an idle brain. They got of nothing but vain fantasy, which is thin of substance as the air, and more inconstant than the wind, who woos even now the frozen bosoms of the north. And, being angered, puffs away from them, turning their face to the dew, dropping sap.
Talk of blows us from ourselves. The supper is done, and we shall come too late.
I fear too early, for my mind misgives some consequent it hanging in the stars. But he that hath the steerage of my course, direct my sail.
Yes!
On, lusty gentlemen.
Strike drum!
Gentlemen, ladies that have their toes unplagued with corns will walk about with you. Ah, my mistresses, which of you all will now deny to dance? She that makes dainty, she, I swear, have corns. Am I come near ye now? Welcome, gentlemen. I have seen the day that I have worn a visor and could tell a whispering tale in a fair lady's ear. Ah, such as would please. Ah, tis gone. Ah, you are welcome, gentlemen.
Thank you.
Come, musicians, play.
That which doth enrich the hand of yonder knight. Oh, she doth teach the torches to burn bright. Did my heart love till now? Forswear it, sight, for I ne'er saw true beauty till this night.
This by his voice be a Montague. What dares the slave? Come hither,
covered in antic face, to fleer and scorn at our solemnity. Now by the stock in honor of my kin, to strike him down, I hold it not a sin.
How now, kinsman? Wherefore storm you so?
Uncle, this is Montague, our foe. A slave come hither in spite to scorn at our solemnity this night.
Young Romeo, is it?
Tis, that villain Romeo.
Oh, content thee, gentle cuz. Let him alone. I would not for the wealth of all the town here in my house do him disparagement. Therefore, be patient. Take no note of him.
It's this. When such a villain is our guest, I'll not endure him.
He shall be endured, what good man Foy. I say he shall. Am I the master here, or you? Go to!
Uncle, 'tis a pity.
Oh, you are a saucy boy. Is it so indeed you must contrary me? Mary, 'tis time. You are a princox. Go to!
Cheerly, my heart. Patience perforce, with willful collar greeting, makes my flesh tremble at their different greeting. I will withdraw, but this intrusion shall, now seemingly sweet, convert to bitterest gall.
If I may profane with my unworthiest hand this holy shrine, the gentle sin is this. My lips, two blushing pilgrims ready stand to smooth that rough touch with a tender kiss.
Good pilgrim, you do wrong your hand too much, which mannerly devotion shows in this. For sainted hands, which pilgrims' hands do touch, and palm to palm is holy palmer's kiss.
Have not saints' lips and holy palmer's too?
Aye, pilgrim. Lips that they must use in prayer.
Oh, well then, dear saints, let lips do what hands do. They pray. Grant thou, lest faith turn to despair.
Saints do not move, though grant for prayer's sake.
Then move not. All my prayer's effect I take. Thus from my lips, my sin is purged.
Then have my lips the sin that they have took?
Sin from my lips? Oh, trespass sweetly urged. Give me my sin again.
You kiss by the book.
What?
Madam, your mother craves a word with you.
Oh. Sorry. What, Mom?
What is her mother?
Oh, Mary Bachelor. Her mother is the lady of the house. Oh, and a good lady, and a wise and virtuous. I nursed her daughter that you talked with all. Oh, let me tell you, he that can lay hold of her shall have the chance.
Is she a Capulet? Oh, dear accounts, my life is my foe's debt.
Away, be gone, the sport is at the best.
Aye, so I fear. The more is my rest. Let's get the hell out of here.
Hey, gentlemen, prepare not to be gone. We have a trifling, foolish banquet towards.
It's getting late.
Yeah.
Is it and so?
It is and yep. So.
Well, then I thank you, honest gentlemen. Okay. I thank you. Good night.
Come hither, nurse.
Come in.
What is yon gentleman?
Oh, the son and heir of old Tiberio.
What's he that now is going out of door?
Mary, that I think be young Petruchio.
What's he that follows here?
I know not.
Well, ask his name. If he be married, my grave is like to be my wedding bed.
His name is Romeo, and a Montague, the only son of your great enemy.
My only love sprung from my only hate. Too early seen unknown, and known too late. Prodigious birth of love it is to me, that I must love a loathed enemy.
What's this? What's this?
A rhyme I learned even now, when I danced withal. Juliet.
Come, let's away. The strangers are all gone. Come along.
Lucky.
Yeah.
Can I go forward when my heart is here? Turn back, dull earth, and find thy center out.
Romeo!
Romeo!
My cousin Romeo!
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 He is wise. Now my life hath fallen home to bed.
He ran this way and left this orchard wall. Call, good Mercutio.
Nay. I'll conjure, too.
Oh, God.
Romeo! Humors, madmen, passion. Passion. Give it some passion, woman.
Passion.
Lover. Appear now in the likeness of a sigh. Speak but one rhyme and I am satisfied. Cry I me, pronounce love and dove. Speak to my gossip Venus one fair word. He heareth not. He moveth not. He stirreth not. The ape is dead.
Eh? And I must conjure.
I conjure thee by Rosaline's bright eye, by her high forehead,
blue, 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 blue.
By her scarlet lips, by her straight leg, by foot, and quivering thigh.
And if he hear thee, thou wilt anger him.
This cannot anger him. Twould anger him to raise a spirit in his mistress' circle. Let it there stand till she had laid it and conjured it down. That were some spite. My invocation is fair and honest. In his mistress' name I conjure thee but to raise him up!
Come. He hath hid himself among these trees to be consorted with a humorous knight. Blind is his love, and best befits the dark.
His love be blind. Thou cannot hit the mark. Romeo, good night. Call to my truckle bed. This field bed is too cold for me to sleep in. Come, shall we go?
Go then, for 'tis in vain to seek him here that means not to be found.
He jests at scars that never felt a wound. But soft! What light through yonder window breaks? It is the east! And Juliet is the sun. Arise, fair sun, and kill thy envious moon, who is already sick and pale with grief, and thou her maid art far more fair than she. Oh, it is my lady. Oh, it is my love. Oh, that she knew. She speaks, yet she says nothing. And what of that? See how she leans her cheek upon her hand? Oh, that I were a glove upon that hand, that I might touch that cheek.
Ay me.
She speaks! Oh, speak again, bright angel.
Oh, Romeo. Romeo? Wherefore art thou, Romeo?
That's me.
Deny thy father and refuse thy name. Or if thou wilt not, be but sworn, my love, and I'll no longer be a captive.
Shall I hear more? Or shall I speak at this?
Girl on hell.
Tis but thy name that is my enemy. Thou art thyself, though not a Montague. What's a Montague? Tis nor hand, nor foot, nor arm, nor face, nor any other part belonging to a man. Oh, be some other name. What is in a name? Thou which would call a rose by any other word would smell as sweet. So Romeo would, were he not Romeo called, retain that dear perfection which he owes without that title. O Romeo, doff thy name, and for that name which is no part of thee, take all myself.
I take thee at thy word!